I'm Sharon Macklis, Director of Editorial Data and Analytics at IDG Communications. I'm here with Episode 7 of Do More With R, Maps. Not too long ago, analyzing geospatial data in R was pretty cumbersome. But that's changed. The SF package implemented a standard called Simple Features for R. And now, packages like ggplot2, tmap, and leaflet support SF. As someone tweeted to me the other day, SF makes GIS in R a joy. Let me show you how. I've got a shapefile of counties in California. That's a geospatial file with boundary information for each county. And I have a separate CSV data file of median household income by county. I'd like to map income by county. First, I'll load some packages. Then I'll set my options so numbers don't display a scientific notation. That's the SciPen equals 999. Reading in the CSV file is pretty straightforward. I'll use readr to import the income data, although you could also use base-r's read.csv. How to get the shapefile into R? It's just as easy as reading in a CSV file if you use the SF package's st_read function. Let's take a look at this MyMap object. It's a data frame and also an SF object. The structure should look pretty familiar. It's a regular data frame with geometry tucked into a special geometry column. That makes it pretty easy to work with. Let me show you what things looked like before Simple Features. That's a large spatial polygons data frame, which is what we typically used for choropleth maps before SF. Because MyMap is basically just a special type of data frame, it's easy to join MyMap with MyData. I can use a regular dplyr inner join. That returns all rows from the first object where there are matches in the second object using a common key column. Now I've got my geospatial object with median income for each county. Time to map. I can create a choropleth map with ggplot2, and it works just like any other kind of ggplot viz, although it might take a little bit longer. If you've used ggplot2 before, this should look familiar. The first line creates a ggplot2 object using data from the map and data frame. The next line says what kind of visualization this should be, in this case an SF geom, and the fill color should be based on the median income column. ggplot defaults to the darker color mapping to the smaller number. In my opinion, that doesn't make much sense for income, so I'll change that using the scale fill gradient function, setting the low and high colors manually. Let me run that. And I can pop this out so you can see it better. Before wrapping up, I want to show you another package for mapping simple features objects, tmap. I know more people are already familiar with ggplot2, but tmap is my favorite for making maps. The syntax is similar to ggplot2. The first line creates a tmap object from the map and data frame. The second line of code says, I want to add polygons colored by the median income column. The identification field for each polygon is the name column, which is the county name. And I decided I'd like a palette of greens instead of the default orange. Let me zoom that so you can see it better. And we've got a nice static map. But it gets cooler because I can turn that map into an interactive JavaScript map with two lines of code. The first line here sets tmap viewing mode to view, which is tmap speak for interactive. The second line redraws the map I just made. I'll need to open this up in a browser so you can see it. I can hover over this to get the county names, and I can click to get the data. You can zoom this. You can even change the underlying map. And finally, you can save either the static map as a JPEG or PNG, or save the HTML map in a standalone file with tmap save. Let me go back to R and show you that. I'm saving that last map in an object called test underscore map, and now I'm saving that into an HTML file. And you can see, there it is. Pretty neat. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, please head to the More with R video page at bit.ly/morewithr. That's https://bit.ly/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. So long, and hope to see you next episode.